1,154.
That's the number of people who have died worldwide from H1N1 flu virus since the virus emerged in April, according to the World Health Organization. The latest count in the U.S. is 353 deaths. While the virus does continue to spread, the WHO says there's no evidence it's mutating into a more dangerous form. Even with concerns over the H1N1 virus slowly subsiding, metro school districts aren't taking any chances with the start of classes drawing near. KMBC9's Justin Robinson has more from Ladd Elementary School. Justin?
While a lot of the talk about the H1N1 virus has died down since last spring, the health department says people should be concerned, especially as students head back to the classroom. With masks on their faces, goggles on their eyes, and disinfectant in hand, the custodial crew at Ladd Elementary School attempts to wipe away the threat of the H1N1 virus.
We change from our normal mild soap and warm water solution to a disinfectant when there's an accelerated concern.
All across the metro, school officials and the health department are working together and taking the virus seriously. They are talking about how students will get the vaccine when it becomes available, how staff and schools will protect themselves and students from someone who does become ill, and what will go into the decision to close a school.
One message, though, that I would really recommend for parents is they need to think about all these plans. If they can stockpile food and water, if we have a major pandemic, the chances that food's going to be available in the grocery store may not be.
That may sound like overreacting, but the health department says one in every 300 Americans has the H1N1 virus. That equates to about 1,000 people in the metro. And it will become more difficult to keep people healthy if the virus changes this school year.
What I'm telling you today on Tuesday may be different tomorrow. I mean, that's how fast these things can change. And so we're telling people, get prepared, stay tuned.
To keep parents informed, the KC School District will post information about the H1N1 virus on their website. To get there, you can go to our website, KMBC.com. Reporting from Ladd Elementary School, Justin Robinson, KMBC 9 News.
Thanks, Justin. Also go to our website for complete back-to-school coverage for all school districts. You'll also find links to the Center for Disease so you can find the latest information about the H1N1 virus.